going on, everyone? Welcome back to yet another installation of Fantasy Factor. As always, I'm Mike, he's Matt, and let's waste no time. Matt, tell me, who is your surprise player of the week?
My surprise player of the week is undisputedly Tyler Lockett. Mm-hmm. 15 receptions, 200 yards, and three touchdowns. With an even 53 fantasy points, he saved a lot of fantasy matchups this weekend, including yours, if I'm not mistaken, right, Mike?
Oh, that's absolutely right, Matt. I was losing by 79 points going into Sunday night's matchup between the Seahawks and Cardinals, which, by the way, was a great game to watch. The Cardinals knocked off the undefeated Seahawks in overtime. However, thanks to Kyler Murray and Tyler Lockett, I was able to win by 4 points. Now let's talk about my surprise player of the week, since Matt stole Lockett from me. I'm going to have to go with the best commercial actor of all time. That's right, Baker Mayfield. After going 0-for-5 with an interception through the first quarter against the Bengals, Baker only missed one throw for the rest of the game, and that was a spike to set up the game-winning touchdown with 11 seconds left. He went for 5 touchdowns as the Browns improved to 5-2 in the year. Now, let's get into the top 10 players of the week. Matt?
All right, first up we have Tyler Lockett. Like we just said, absolutely stunning performance. 53 points, made a lot of fantasy owners happy. Second, we have Davante Adams, another 40-plus point game in like 4 games that he's played with 44.6 points. Mm-hmm. Next up, we have Justin Herbert, 38.5 points. The rookie just continuing to shine for the Chargers this year. Every week that he plays, you can just tell how bright the future is for him. Next, we have Kyler Murray, 38.1 points. Kyler absolutely shined in the surprising win against the Seahawks. And at fifth, we have Tom Brady, 36.9. How I miss you, Tommy. Continues to prove the haters wrong at 43 years old. He just got Antonio Brown. I don't want to jinx anything, but I'm starting to think this team might have a shot.
And then we got Joe Burrow, 34.6. He's starting to prove that he is deserving of that number one overall pick. Then we got Russell Wilson, 32.9. The MVP frontrunner put up another great performance, which could have been 6 points better if he did not throw 3 interceptions. Jeff Wilson Jr., yet another undrafted free agent running back making a name for himself. He had 3 touchdowns against the Patriots before leaving the game with an injury. Then we go to James Robinson, yet another undrafted rookie. This one out of Illinois State. He went for 2 touchdowns, over 100 yards in a road loss against the Texans. Then we have Baker Mayfield. Oh, yes, the man, the myth, the legend, the one who is supposed to save Cleveland. And I think he's going to save Cleveland, Matt. I really do. The Browns are currently in the 6th seed in the playoff hunt, and it's looking up from there.
All right, now the top 10's out of the way. Let's go to another short rise-fall segment. One undefeated team left, and who would have guessed it would be the Pittsburgh Steelers? I got to give them props that they're playing out of their minds. Regardless of the almost comeback from the Titans, they're heading to Baltimore to take on the Ravens. Mike, what do you think is going to happen?
So first off, it goes without saying this will be a great game. Two super hot teams fighting for the top spot in the AFC North. They won't hold it for very long. The Browns are coming for it. But regardless, I think it's going to be whoever wins the turnover battle, and I think that will be the Ravens. I think Lamar's going to be able to escape that daunting Steelers pass rush, and in the end, that'll be too much for the Steelers.
I seem to be wrong on all my rise and fall picks lately, and maybe I'm just jinxing these teams. But I'm going to go with the Steelers. They've shown that their defense is absolutely insane. Their offense isn't too shabby with Big Ben back either. Eric Ebron, Chase Claypool, Juju are catching passes, and it's winning games. I think it'll be a close game, but I think it'll be the Steelers that win. I hope I didn't jinx them.
Now let's head to add drop. Matt, name a player you think people should add or drop ahead of the midway point in the season.
Before speaking too early, I think I might be right with adding Gronk last week, so there's a little tire pump for myself.
Of course.
But I think adding one of the Eagles wide receivers this week would be good. They've had a lot of trouble with injuries, but I think Travis Fulgham has been pretty consistent since week 4. If you have an extra guy out for a bye week or an injury or something, I think he's a good add.
An absolute must drop for me is Cowboys receiver Michael Gallup. I have been very patient with Gallup early on. He seemed like a consistent 10-point scorer, but ever since Dak Prescott went down with that gruesome knee injury, Gallup's production has halted. The final straw, if you will, for me was when he scored 0 points against the football team.
All right, guys, that's all the time we have for Fantasy Facts today. As always, thanks for watching. Next to Mike LaGage, I'm Matt Gagnon. Peace out.